This video is going to be about transposing or transposition. In terms of what transposition is, it's really just about moving the pitch of an overall piece of music, like an overall sort of whole melody or series of chords, essentially. So moving it all up or down in pitch, and essentially moving it to another key. So this is really, really common in a lot of kind of more classical music. Often sections of music, like a little theme, might be repeated but in a different key, but for a lot more pop rock and jazz musicians, it's much more common to transpose to try and find new keys for a singer. So maybe this piece of music is a bit low for a singer, so they want to move it all up to a higher key, essentially, and move it up in pitch. So that's a really common thing. And also, same with classical world, but jazz too, some instruments are transposing instruments. So where they see a C, they might actually be, what you might hear when they play that instrument and see that note is, say, a B flat or an E flat, essentially, or an F or something. So there are instruments out there, and particularly saxophones. Saxophones tend to be transposing instruments. So if you want to write notes down for a saxophone, and you wanted to hear a C, D, E, and F, you wouldn't end up writing them, really. You would probably end up writing some different notes that transpose to the key of the instrument. So I'm going to go over how to transpose. People think it's quite a challenging thing to do, but actually, if you're confident with your keys, scales, and intervals, it's not that hard, really. So this first exercise, I'm being asked to transpose up a tone. So this is the method, really. The first thing I need to do is look at the original piece of music, figure out what the key is. So there's no key signature, it's probably C or A minor, starts with a C, finishes with a G7. So when we have like a seven chord, it's a dominant chord. They tend to only usually fall on chord five in a key, major or minor. So if this is five, then we go five, you know, F is 4, E is 3, D is 2, and that would make C1. So looking at this piece of music, we could pretty much assume it's in C major from looking at those things. So once I've figured out it's in C, the next thing I need to think is maybe the singer, and this is really common, I've been asked this so many times, is that, oh, can you just bump it up a tone? You know, they just want it a bit higher to suit their voice maybe and their range. So you need to think, well, upper tone. So the original key is C. So a tone above a C is, well, C, C sharp, D. So it's the key of D. So we're going to take all this and move it to the key of D. And there are a few different ways that you can transpose. And I'd say that you need to know them all, really, because, or at least two methods. Because one's really good to think about for guitarists and writing down on notation, whereas another method is much better for a lot of other instruments like the piano and things like that, essentially. So I transpose differently depending really on how much of a key change it is and what instrument I'm playing. So this is how we do it. So we've got a C, we're in the key of C, we're going up a tone to the key of D. So one way I could do this is to look at the melody and rewrite the melody or up. So a tone is one sort of step along because it's a major second. We're going to move all the notes up a second. So instead of a C in the original melody, I'm going to write a D, essentially. And I'm not going to worry about sharps or flats for now. I'll figure that out in a minute and you'll see how that works. But this D is going to go up to the next letter, basically, in the scale. So E, it's going to go up to E. And this E is going to go up to F. Some of you might be thinking, well, John, that's not a tone, but don't worry, we'll come back to that. So I'm just going up kind of the amount of the scale degrees. So a C to a D is just one step, essentially, along the alphabet. So an F goes up to a G, and then a G goes up to an A, and then we've got that F here, so that's going to go up to a G. Then we go, an A becomes a B, a C becomes a D, B becomes a C, and a C becomes a D. You could have obviously copied and pasted and moved it, but as you'll see, that actually in this program, gives you almost too much of a shortcut to really understand what's going on. So that last G becomes an A, F becomes a G. Yeah, so what you should be able to see is almost visually, you can see it's the same. Oh, I've gone wrong somewhere. I missed one. Missed that one down there, didn't I? Right, so. There we go. So you see that visually it's the same. It's, you know, it's all looks very similar, but every note is one step along the kind of scale degrees, or one step along the alphabet, really. So C has gone to a D, whereas G's gone to an A. I'm not worried about sharps or flats. This isn't a proper transposition. Now, what I could do is now just put the key signature in the new key. So the original key was C major. Yeah, we have to go up to D major. So I just put in the D major key signature, right? So if we go and add a key signature for the key of D major, which is the new key we're going to, the beginning here, right, like that, then you can see some notes are obviously not in the key, and I just have to move them to get them in the key, or I can just delete out the natural signs. Yeah, now this isn't the most efficient way of doing this, but it's to get the idea of now those notes that I've just changed have been altered, they've all been raised. So any F's have become from F naturals to F sharps, any C's have gone to C sharp. And now our melody is exactly the same, but it's in the key of D, not in the key of C, essentially. So if we listen to it originally, louder. Right, so then in a new key, that is a melody transposed. I could do the same for the bass parts. What we could have done to save a bit of time is in this program, actually copy, paste, and I'll just raise it all up one. Although none of my keys seem to be actually working on the keyboard for some reason at the moment. But if I just hit the up button, it would go into the correct key. So if I just move them manually up, I've already got the key signature in there, so it's going to naturally get them all right anyway for me. Oh, there we go. Yeah, so are there any that would have changed? I don't think so, actually, in the bass part. Anyway, so that would now work with the bass part. Now that we've got the chords, so this is where, you know, we've been making these tables of all of the kind of scale degrees, and then what notes are in each chord, and then what the chords are called. If we made one for C major and made one for D major, we'd be able to check out and see what the new chords are going to be called. One thing to note is that actually all the chord types are going to be the same, essentially. Yeah. So if it was originally in a major 7 chord, in the new key it's going to be a major 7. It's just going to be the root note that changes, essentially. The type of chord that it is, it's going to stay the same. We could make these charts, and then we'd be able to see that actually, well, C obviously goes up to a D because that's the key change we're trying to make. And we know we're going up a tone, so a G up a tone is an A, and an F up a tone is a G. That's going to be a B, that's going to be a G, and a G up a tone is an A. Essentially, yeah. So that there is a perfect transposition of the original melody, essentially, yeah? That's how to do it. So remember, what we did is we established what is the key of the original piece, where's kind of the tonic, where's chord one, where there it is at the beginning, and then think, well, if you need to get up a tone, then you need to work out what the distance is. So C, C sharp to D is a tone. So the new key is going to be D major. And then we just move all of the kind of notes up that amount of the letters, the scale letters, and apply the key signature of the new key, and we're done. Yeah, and then you just need to change the kind of the first part of each chord, like the root note. Essentially, create these chord tables for the two keys to help you work that out, or just move it up by the interval amount, yeah, for the tone. So that's how to do it by a tone. But we have another type of transpositions where you're actually told to what key to go to, essentially. So this one we were told we want to go up a tone. This one we're being told we want to move this piece of music from C major to the key of E flat major. So there's almost like a little step we need to just work out, which is what's the distance between C and E flat, essentially. And this is where we have two kind of ways of doing it. So if we kind of work it out, well, we've got if we count like semitones, C, C sharp, D, E flat. Yeah, so three semitones on. And if you remember from our interval sessions, three semitones is a minor third. So we're going to move this up a minor third, essentially, to the key of E flat major. Now, one way to do it would be like we've just done. Key of E flat major, I'm going to put in the key signature to start with, actually. So E flat major has three flats. Stick it in. Take this piece of music. There we go. Rewrite it. And what I need to do is make sure that it all moves up with a C going to an E flat. Yeah? So three semitones up. So one semitone, two semitones, three semitones. And can you see, because in the original piece of music there's no sharps or flats, there's no accidentals. Now, because I put the key signature in first, there's no sharps or flats, because all these notes are in the key of E flat. Done. Yeah? So what we did to do that is worked out the distance between the original key and the new key of E flat, essentially, which was a minor third. And then we put in the key signature of the new key and move everything up a minor third, or three semitones, essentially. And you're in the key. We need to do the chords, and we could do the chord charts again, or we could just move everything up a minor third. So C goes, you know, C sharp, D, and then obviously to E flat. This one goes up from G to A flat to A, to B flat, yeah. And also, actually, we'll just keep on doing it like this for a second. So this goes F, G flat, G, and then A flat. Do you notice that I'm trying to keep them all flat, because it's a flat key signature as well? A minor goes up to C minor, and this goes to A flat. And this goes to B flat. Now, this is all very useful if you're transposing on a piece of paper like this, yeah? Really, really useful, really easy way to do it. But often you're having to transpose on the fly in your head. Now, to do this, you know, when you're sat at the piano and your guitar and things like that, to do this, you need to think a little bit differently about music. And this is really how you should think about music anyway. So get rid of all this. I want to think about how I might do this if I was actually doing it for real, sat down at my piano. What I think is actually the chord progression for a start is not C major. I'm in the key of C major, but I would think that this chord is actually chord one, yeah? Whereas this chord is actually chord five. And this chord is actually chord four. Yeah? This is how we should be really thinking. We're in the key of C major. The chord progression is one, major seven, maybe, five, seven. And we can work this out. If we have one of those chord chart things, then you could just look at it and see where they are. Whereas A minor is really chord six. And a common thing to do is to write down, minor chords with lowercase Roman numerals. So we've got chord four and chord five again. So actually, if I was really thinking about this as a real musician playing it, not so much kind of doing this all on paper, but doing it in my head on the fly in a rehearsal room, when a singer's shouting at you, they want to change the key, I would think of the chord progression more like this anyway. But you really should start thinking about chord progressions like this. What's the key, and what function does each chord serve in the key? And then if I want to go to the chord, the key of D major, well, I just think about the new key, and chord one in the key of D major is a D major 7. Yeah, and then chord 5 in the key of D major is A7. Yeah, and then chord 4 in the key of D major 7 is G major 7. Chord 6 in the key of D major 7 is B minor 7. Yeah, so you see the idea. And actually, if I think of this melody as more like this, so that is the root note in the key of C major. C is the root. D is the second note. You see how when I'm talking about actual notes, I'm using normal numbers, whereas when I'm talking about chords within a key, I use Roman numerals. So this is the third note in the key. Yeah. So this would be the fourth, the fifth, then back to 4, 6, root at the octave. This is like the seventh over here. So you put 7 by that one. Yeah. So if you were to think about this melody as a musician that could transpose on the fly really easily, I would not think of it like C, D, E, F, G. I would think of it 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 4, 6, you know, octave, 7 octave, 5, 3, 4, 5, 4, 3, 2, 5, 2. That's how you should really think about it, because then when you come to transpose it in your head, when you're working in a band, it's a fast environment, a rehearsal, suddenly you are thinking about, okay, so we're now in the key of D major, and it goes root, second, third, fourth, and then fifth with a minim, yeah? And then if I'm looking up here, this goes to the fourth, so the fourth in the key is there. Then it goes to the sixth, and then it goes to the octave, and then it goes to the seventh, and then the octave on a crop tip. Yeah? So it's the same functions, it's just different key, yeah? So root, second, third, fourth, fifth, yeah, and then you've got these sort of notes, 7 octave and stuff. And that's another way to think. And this is a really, really good way to think if you're in a rehearsal and you're working with a live band and things like that. Actually, think of all the chords as what function they serve in the key. Are they the first, the fifth, the fourth, sixth? Are they alterations? So we looked at like flat 3, flat 7, really common in pop rock, stuff like that. And then with the melody, is it, you know, don't think of it as D, E, F sharp, G, A. Think of it as 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yeah, because then if I'm in the key of F sharp, so we know that F sharp is all sharps apart from B is natural, right? So suddenly this key, this in the key of F sharp would be F sharp, G sharp, A sharp, B, C sharp. We pick another key, like, I don't know, D flat. It'd be, you know, D flat, E flat, F, G flat, A flat. You know, because that's the notes in that key. So this is the way to really think about music if you want to really understand how music works. And also at the same time, it will allow you to transpose really fast on the fly. Now, the one thing you need to be wary of is, let's say in the original piece of music, at the minute it's all within the key. Let's say suddenly they stuck a, where could we stick something interesting? Let's say on this one, they wanted to go to a minor chord 4. So actually it was going to be, not F major 7, F minor 7. So they've changed, lowered the third, essentially, yeah? So all we need to do is to clock that and think about coming back to it, yeah? Because that's an alteration, it's outside of the key of C major, yeah? But it's the sixth note that's been flattened. So if I was thinking about this, like I was just saying, I go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, for flat six. So instead of it being a normal six there, we're going to flatten it or lower it. Yes, this has been lowered, so I'm going to lower it. So there. Yeah, so we just need to come back to any accidentals in the original piece that's outside the key. All you need to do is, once you've got it all working inside the key nicely, is just come back and lower that one. And if you're doing it on the fly, then you have to think of it like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 for flat six. Yeah? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 for flat six. And that is how to transpose really fast on the fly with accidentals as well. Okay?